Hello everyone and welcome. My name's Claudio. So glad that you're here. If you are visiting for the first time, thank you so much for stopping by. And if you're returning, thank you as well. Today I'm sharing with you one of my Adobe Express workflow tips when I'm creating content that I share on Instagram or any other social media platform. So let's go ahead and dive right in. I'm demoing this on my mobile because this is where I do a lot of my workflow for social, but you can do this on the web version as well. I'm going to tap on the plus sign here and I'm going to choose photos from my Lightroom because that's where I tend to edit all my photos that I share on social. And let me go ahead and find a library of photos that I took recently. Here is a New York trip, really great place for taking photos. And so here's my workflow. What I'll do is I'll choose one photo, I'll start with one, and I'll choose my Instagram portrait size because that's where I'm going to share this one. I'll go ahead and choose done. And I'm going to remove that text here. And next is just make a little bit of an adjustment to the photo. And then I'll choose add. And then here's where I go and add my logos. If you're not familiar with how to add logos, you can check out the link in the description below on how to add your own logos to your account in Adobe Express. This is the logo that I'll use, and usually it automatically sets it in the right spot. You can go ahead and make adjustments to it. You can scale that down, make it larger, and use the nudge feature to move it to the corners a little closer to where you want it to be. And there we go. So I've got my photo, my content that I share on social, and then I add my logo and anything else that I would want to have. You know, maybe there's some text that I want it to be consistent throughout all the different frames that I use. But for now, it's just my photo. And then I have my logo, which is going to be on all my pictures that I create here. Now, the next step is to go up to the double button up there at the top, which you'll also see on the web version. And here it is selected. And what I'll do is I will duplicate this several times. And depending on how many photos I have to share, I'll just go ahead and create six. And then I just go ahead and double tap and it brings me back into the project. I'll go ahead and tap on the photo, choose replace. And again, I'm going to go to Lightroom. And again, go and select my photos from my Lightroom library here. So here we go. Let's go ahead and scroll down. I'll go ahead and find another photo, this one right here. And there's the logo. It's in the same spot. It won't change. And again, just repeat the process. I'll go ahead and go to the top. I'll double tap the next one and I'll just continue on doing the same steps. Select, replace, go to Lightroom, and continue doing this until I have all my photos in the same spot. And then we're gonna do the next step. All my photos have been added to the Adobe Express project here, all six pages, as you can see here. The great thing about this workflow is the logo is in the same spot. And then if I had any text or anything else added, again, the original one, duplicate it, and then all the other ones, all I need to do is just swap out the photo and everything else is intact, just making my workflow much easier and faster. Then when I'm ready, I can go ahead and download, choose all pages, and then download, and I'm ready to post on social or wherever I want to share these. So the next time you're in Adobe Express, give this tip a try. If you have any comments or questions about this video, please do drop it in the comment section below. Don't forget, like, subscribe, click the bell to be notified for future videos, and please share this video with your friends. Until next time, be good to one another. Peace.